broadcast house and digitized over 20,000 unseen images of Uganda's history.
In January this year, the University of Michigan from the United States of America entered into a partnership with UBC TV to support it digitize the available photo archives.
Right now, as we speak, we are really grateful for the partnerships that we've started off with. The University of Michigan, led by Professor Derek Peterson, who came on board helping us to start off the archiving with... we were anticipating to have 10,000 negatives. These are still photographs dating back from the 50s, 60s. We found out after putting everything together that we have over 80,000 negatives. And of these, 25,000 have already been digitized with the funding from the University of Michigan. And we are indeed grateful for that help.
Led by Professor Derek Peterson, the team was beefed up by Makerere University students and UBC TV librarians. For close to 8 months, the team endured the Herculean task of sorting, cleaning, and loading the over 70,000 negatives into crates before scanning them.
We have a range of number of images. Some of them had only two or three, others had several hundred. So we would take an envelope. To scan it requires special equipment. As I said, a physical negative is about that big. So unless you have very good eyes, it's very difficult to see all the detail inside it. So with this catalog, we take the negative to the scanner here, which is the work going on behind me. They begin the scanning process and begin to see what is actually in these images.
But what makes this collection special?
Depending on where you sit, a public occasion, a policy, a new initiative, a great event looks quite differently. Because these photographs are so numerous, 50,000 from the 1960s and 70s, of all kinds of occasions, both great and small, because they're so numerous, there's all kinds of different angles that one can get into Uganda's history from looking at them. It's not the single shot. There's a few images of, for instance, Idi Amin, which have become iconic because they represent a particular view of the Amin government. Those images often associate the Amin regime with violence and tyranny and destruction and terror. What these images show is a rather different kind of story. They show us that actually the Amin government was a rationally organized political setup which a lot of people supported, which people greeted with enthusiasm. We can see here public occasions when all kinds of people, great and small, are involved in a very positive and celebratory way in public occasions.
Indeed, the photos are so unique in nature, revisiting the tenure of Presidents Kabaka Mutesa, Obote, Idi Amin, and the early days of the NRA. Some of these photographs are to be printed and exhibited by the broadcaster at the Uganda Museum.
A selection of those photographs and making them available in large prints in the museum special gallery, special exhibition gallery, so that viewers who want to learn about the 1970s from a new point of view can benefit from this new collection. So that will be a public event which will be advertised. UBC will be one of the key organizers of that occasion, along with the Uganda Museum. And together, these two public entities will open up this collection for Uganda citizens to learn from.
UBC's Managing Director Winston Agaba says these digitized archives are to be incorporated into daily programming and will be used by others for study purposes.
All these are in place to make sure that we can preserve this archive for posterity and also to play it back for the audiences in Uganda to appreciate the rich history of what has happened in the past. And we believe that it's going to be very informative, very educative, once we have all this material digitized.
Agaba adds that these archives will also play a vital role in helping biopic movie directors.
One issue about the archived material that we hold at UBC, it's rich in the sense that so many things can be gotten out of it. An example is the recently shot movie in Uganda, The 27 Guns. UBC was vital in providing some of the footage which was used in that movie.
After years of neglect and bad storage, Agaba says that the corporation he heads will put in place systems to preserve this fragile media. Samuel Ssenono, UBC News.